Episode 3071, A Captured Heart.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy every day. I hope you're readying your heart for yes. Fry. Yay! Oh, come on. I'm so excited. I need rest. That's all I gotta say. It has been a long week. I've been traveling. I've been painting. I've been spending time with my grandbaby. And this grandmama is exhausted. But I'm still here with you. And you know what? We've got Father's Day around the corner. So it's all about a captured heart. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by AIM, inspiring connection and community. Let me remind you here real quick that if you want to become a part of our free community, our family, head on over to createyournow.mn.co. You can also find the information on createyournow.com along with in the show notes. So take a deep breath. As Father's Day approaches, let's recognize the pressures many dads place on themselves to be perfect. But the truth is, being a great dad isn't about being flawless and having all the answers. What dads need is a captured heart. Now, I know some of you are thinking, well, you didn't know my dad. You don't know the dad of my children. Okay, we all have different dads. We all have different role models. And what I want you to think about right now is that we need to be able to lift up the men in our life. And men, if you're listening, I want you to feel lifted up today. Because I believe dads get a bad rap. And there are a lot of men out there that want to do really, really good by their children and by the women that they love. But the problem is that they're caught between a rock and a hard place. Mainly, yes, being the provider. Now, not all dads are the provider. We have a lot of stay-at-home dads. I get that. The world is different. However, I would say this. There's still this pull that I've got to be everything to my child. And as a woman, I don't think we really think a lot about how the man feels. We take it somewhat for granted because we were created as nurturers. It's just something that is innate within us. And God created men to be providers. Now, I'm not saying that women can't work. Oh, no, don't send me those hate emails. And I'm not saying men can't stay home and be nurturers. I'm not saying that at all. But what I am saying is we have these natural tendencies that go with our personalities. They are ingrained in ourselves within who we are. And so what happens is it really can complicate the situation, honestly, when we become moms or dads. So today I really want to honor our dads. Number one, I have an incredible dad, and he was taken home too soon, in my opinion. I know God would argue otherwise because, you know, it was one of those things. He was called home, and we miss him greatly. And so I was very, very blessed to have a dad who loved me, would do anything for me. And we didn't have absolutely everything in the world. We were not rich. We were not poor, but we were not middle class either. We were loved. We were provided for. And so I don't put myself in a class. And I think sometimes when we look at our world today, it's like we have to hit a certain status. I've got to be, you've heard the saying, I got to be like the Joneses. I'm sorry if you have that last name. It's nothing personal. I don't know where that came from. I should look it up one of these days because maybe we need to change that name. But if you're always trying to reach a certain status, when are you going to be who God created you to be as a parent, as a mom, as a dad, right? Because let's go back to being dads here for a moment, okay? Dads have a lot of pressure, especially if they are the provider in the family. That's a lot to carry. And so our dads think, gosh, I gotta be like perfect. I gotta be able to handle everything. Yet they have a really difficult time. Why? Because they just have a very difficult time. They're not created in that manner to do everything. Now, women, I'm not saying we can do everything, but we come at it from a different perspective. Okay, that is what I'm saying. Now, we have those few exceptions to the rules, but we'll leave that for another episode. So when we look at our dads wanting to be flawless, right? That's what you guys want. And you want to have all the answers for your kiddos. You want to be providing everything for them. But what you really need is a captured heart. Because when a father's heart is captured by the love for his children, all the other pieces seem to fall into place. Father's Day is a special day. And it's dedicated to honoring the men who sacrifice so much to care for their children and their families. Now, I know maybe you haven't had the best role model. And maybe you grew up as, you know, not having even a dad around. Maybe you right now have kids and your kid's dad is not around. But we have to understand that the dads that are around, we can't lump sum them into, well, they're a man and they just don't know any better. Right, men? I mean, like, seriously. We got to get out of our high horses of lumping everybody and saying, this is what everybody believes. This is how everybody sees it. No, it's not. So I want you to look at your situation. I want you to see dads in a different light, right? Because it's important to recognize that not every parent is perfect. I'm not, you're not. And not everyone, again, has had the best role models to follow. So as women, if you're listening, we can support our men who are fathers and help them adjust to fatherhood. I mean, seriously, think about this. Imagine if parents worked together, how different our world could be. It's not about, I got to be better. I want all the kids to love me. Seriously? You know what? I was a disciplinarian in the family. Still am. We still have kiddos at home. I still have to kind of set the rules. Now, dad follows everything and supports what I do. But why is it me? Because I'm the one who's home. I was primarily with them all the time. Dad was providing for the family. Still is. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's how our family is set up. But it does put a little bit of extra strain on what? On me. Because I'm having to do a lot of other things. However, when I get out of the way, dad steps up. And mom, you know, sometimes we just get in the way of our dads. So you got to be careful with that. We both need to be a part of our kiddos' lives. That's why God invented a man and a woman. Not because they just can procreate. I mean, yes, that's one reason. But it's because the attributes, he did not give one gender all the attributes. He said, I created man and I created woman to make man, right? Better, to come alongside. It's not about the man's better than the woman or vice versa. That's not the conversation we're having here. So I really want you to think, how do you see your kid's dad? I mean, you could be divorced right now, but that doesn't mean that your kids don't have that dad any longer. That dad's always going to be their dad, right? Can't take that away. You can divorce him. You may not be married to him any longer, but to those kids, he's always dad. So what can you do to support the dad in your family? How can you parent well, even if you didn't have a great role model? Well, first, you've got to understand that you do not have to be the perfect parent to make a positive impact on your child's life. Making an effort to support and love your children unconditionally is crucial in their development. Now, that doesn't mean that you say yes to everything. I did not say that. Don't put words in my mouth. Listen carefully. Because we take what we want to hear to make it easy for us. Why do kids get what they want? Because we don't want to discipline. We're too tired. Seriously. Why do kids have a hard time going to bed? Because no doesn't mean no in the household. No means, maybe just a few more minutes. And the kids know that. They use it and take it to their advantage. Come on, mom and dad, we got to step it up. You do not have to be the perfect parent to make a positive impact on your child's life. So spend quality time with them and show genuine interest in their lives. Listen to your kiddos when they talk and validate their feelings. Teach them to be respectful, honest, and responsible. Yes, you can teach them to say, yes, ma'am, no, sir. There's nothing wrong with that. These small actions will go a long way in developing a strong relationship with your child. I know you may not like it at first because it's not easy. I'm sitting here replaying everything because I've, you know, have my grandbaby with me. And he's absolutely precious. He can do no wrong. That's a lie. He does wrong. And guess what? Grandma still has to set the boundaries just as she did with her five children. Now, is he still adorable? Oh, yes, he is. Does he get everything he wants? Oh, no, he does not. I still have those boundaries. I still set things and say, you can't have this. You can't do this. Because if I give him absolutely everything, what is that going to do for him in the long run? How is that going to help him? I mean, seriously, have you asked yourself these questions? Because most of the time we don't. All of a sudden, we walk out with a child in our hand after delivery, and now we're expected to know what to do with this child. Now what do we do with him? You love him. But you've got to be willing to spend that quality time. You got to be there. And I'm not saying you can't miss a game or two or three, but I am saying that you need to spend time with your children. It can't just be FaceTime. It can't be just on Zoom. Now, there are some exceptions to the rule, right? I'm from a military background. We get moms and dads that are sent off for a year to 18 months at times. And yes, so parenting from a Zoom or from FaceTime or handwritten letters, that's important. But remember, that's for a season. You still are setting up time to spend with them. Don't make excuses not to parent because it's all too easy. Seriously. But the one thing you do need to know is you don't have to be perfect. Number two, it's always helpful to seek advice from other parents or experts who have been through similar situations. Join a support group. Attend parenting classes. Right? Get some good books. Listen to podcasts. What do you think we're on here for? Now, that doesn't mean that on podcasts and all that, you've got to know who you're talking to. Do you respect this person that you're listening to? Do they have the same morals and values as you do? Because that goes into a whole other thing, and that goes for people who are leading groups, who you're seeking advice from. I mean, let me ask you this question. Would you go to a person who's been divorced five times and ask them about how to save your marriage? I don't think so. Seriously. I mean, come on. Nope. That's all comedy right there. But there are a lot of people out there that know some ways to get through the season that you're in. So seek out help. Don't be embarrassed. Don't act like, gosh, I'm supposed to have it all together. I should already know this. No, you don't. How do you think I learned? You practice on the first so you can perfect the third. For me, it was the fifth. Still working on that. My fifth is not. So maybe one of these days, maybe my 12th or 15th grandchild, however many I have, the last one, maybe that grandchild will be perfect. And we know that not to be true too. Because we're human beings. We're never going to be perfect. But seek out those who have experience, right? Make an appointment with a child psychologist. If you're having issues, say, you know what? I just don't know how to handle this child. If you've got a gifted and talented child, let me tell you, you've got some issues that you're going to have to deal with as they get older. Not just when they're young, but when they're older. If you have children with disabilities, You're going to have some challenges at different stages. But you can make it through. And you can still love your children while you raise them. Seriously, I know, because there are times you're like, put myself in time out. Where's the duct tape? Because I got to duct tape my mouth. Because you find yourself in these situations as if, I am not making this through. I just can't do this. Furthermore, it's important to recognize your strengths and weaknesses as a parent. It's okay to admit when you're unsure how to handle a situation or when you need to take a break. Like I said, put yourself in time out. I think I've shared this story before, but when we lived in Nebraska, we had this weird house. And I say it's weird. It's one of my favorite houses I've ever lived in. Literally, imagine a house that was just a room off of a room off of a room. The house had no hallways, and it was three stories. Okay, so if you can't imagine it, think about this. Put a box down and then put a box right next to it and just put a door there. There's no hallways to get to it. It's literally a room off of a room off of a room. It was incredible. It was humongous. We lived on 5 acres. It was great. Now, I'm telling you this story. Why? Because you see, during that time, that's when our youngest was in infancy and our oldest was, oh my goodness, I have to think about where we were in ages, was 8 years old. And so we had quite the span there. I was homeschooling them. And there were times that 24/7, 365, mama needed a break. The kids didn't, I did. So I put myself in time out. And the problem was, is I had no place to hide. It was room off of a room off of a room. So what did I do? I put myself in time out. I went to the garage. And if I was so frustrated that I just needed to kind of like scream it out for a moment, it wasn't like a really loud scream, but you know, you get so frustrated. I mean, come on, let's be real. It's confession day. I sat in my vehicle. All right, so there's two doors there, set in my vehicle, my big van, and closed the door, and I was just like, ugh. I'm like, okay, count to 10. If I needed to, count to 20. If I needed to again, count to 50. And I would take a deep breath, and I'd go in and handle the situation. Now, obviously, when I put myself in time out, the kids were safe. Didn't have to worry about it. Made sure the young one was in a safe place. They couldn't do anything crazy, right? Okay, so don't send me those emails either. But we have to understand our strengths and our weaknesses. It's okay to admit when you're unsure how to handle a situation. Seek help from someone professional. Right? Figure out, okay, who in my church, who in my community can I lean on? Right? Don't go talk to somebody who's never had kids. That's just kind of crazy. I'm like, seriously. It's just like going and asking for marital advice from someone who's been divorced 5 times. I don't think it works. Just saying. Let's use some common sense too. Being an incredible dad or mom is not about being perfect, but about putting forth an effort to nurture and to guide your children. They love you no matter how you dress, no matter what you look like, but it does matter how you treat them. You got to love them unconditionally. You got to live with a captured heart. Because if you don't, they're going to find someone else whose heart will be captured. And that's when we get into dangerous situations. That's when we have our kiddos stray. And I'm not saying that they run away. I'm just saying they get into things. And they can get into things anyway. But if we as parents can't be there, dads, they need you. Our kiddos need their dad so much. You're their rock. Moms, you're a rock too, but you're a different rock. So what are you going to do? Are you going to be willing to put aside your perfection and say, you know what? I want my kids to really capture my heart. I want to be able to support them. So I'm going to seek out advice. I'm going to get the support that I need. I'm going to accept my limitations. And I'm always going to show love and understanding toward my children. When you lead with a heart like that, you're going to raise some incredible kids. And I got to tell you this on a side note. It's never too late. If you've been kind of struggling as a parent and you're like, gosh, Christiane, it sounds all great, but my kids are, my youngest is like 10 and my oldest is like 19. I don't know what to do. It's not too late. If you have messed up, guess what? Sit down with them. And if they are older, I would suggest sitting down with them individually. Make it kind of a date night, as in mom and son are going out or dad and son are going out, one-on-one. And sit there and say, you know what? There's a lot of growing up I needed to do. And in your earlier years, I just didn't do everything like I should have done. I want to tell you, I'm sorry for that. I'm sorry that I wasn't doing what I thought I should be doing. I mean, I thought I was doing well, but then as I look back, I could have done better. But I want you to know that regardless, I love you. Wow. That's going to change the tone. That's going to change your heart, your child's heart. And if you've done some things that you're like, oh, Christine, you just don't know what I've done. I've done some things as a person that a person should never do. Go ask for forgiveness. And let me tell you this. This is the hard thing, okay? So hear me out here. Because for some people, Father's Day is very challenging. Because again, a lot of people out there did not have a really good father. So this is a painful time for a lot of people. But if you're finding that you have repeated some of the things that your dad did and you wish you hadn't, I want you to go to your child, regardless of age, but especially the older ones. The young ones, you have to change your vocabulary, obviously, because they're not going to understand a whole lot. But as they get older, especially if they're in their teens, into their 20s and 30s, you can go to them and say, you know, you may not understand this right now, but I need to ask for forgiveness. I need you to forgive me for, and say it. I need you to forgive me for my anger, for lashing out. It's no excuse, but I had a really hard job. And the boss demanded a lot from me, but unfortunately, I took it out on you. And that was wrong. And I ask for your forgiveness. Now, I will also add this. Don't expect them to forgive right then. They're going to have to go through their own process. But let me tell you, what you've done is you have said, I'm sorry. You've asked for forgiveness, and now you leave it at the feet of Jesus. They can take it, as in your children, your child can, and they can decide how they want to interpret that. But if you give them the opportunity to say, I still love you, Dad. I still love you, Mom. That is going to be a moment that you will never forget. But you have to open up that door. And yeah, that means you have to humble yourself. You have to own that, hey, I'm not perfect. I tried to be. I tried to look good. I tried to be that status quo. I wanted to rise up. I wanted to be the king of all dads, the king of all moms. But obviously, I failed. I fell short. And for that, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Now again, they don't have to say right then and there, and I don't want you to expect them to say, I forgive you. They've got to go through their own journey. And it may take weeks, months, years. But let me tell you, you have done your part. And now you can move forward. You don't have to carry that guilt any longer. These are conversations that no one wants to have. But it is the reality of the world we live in. Because we live in a fallen world. We live in a world that, yes, people who love each other, they hurt each other. And that's not fair and that's not right. I know you're probably thinking, Christine, this is supposed to be Friday. Yay! And you're kind of ending on a down note. I don't want to end on a down note, but I do want to be serious. No one's talking about this stuff. How can you change the world and impact the world that you touch if you aren't doing it within your own four walls? We got to step up to our own plate before we can go out and impact the world that we touch. Let me tell you, your influence is humongous. So use your influence now. You don't have to be perfect. You don't have to be flawless. You need to allow your kiddos to capture your heart. They want your presence. So be there with them as much as you can, however that season looks for you. And if you haven't been all that great, then acknowledge it. We all fail. We all fall short. Own it so you can step through and move on from where you are. To all my dads out there, happy Father's Day. I really want you to know that I'm proud of the effort that you're making. It's not easy being a dad. I know. I've watched my husband. I watched my dad in a different way. I was the oldest of three. I was far enough, you know, advanced. I had a younger brother and sister. And so as I got older, I got to see more of how my mom and dad parented them. It was different. Because I was also removed, right? When I'm looking at me, I'm like, okay, well, yeah, I'm perfect. No, I didn't ever say that. Even though it would be nice if I was, but that's for another episode. But seriously, it's interesting how we see our dads. And I just want you to know that you're loved and appreciated. And yes, you're going to have hard times. Moms, you need to lift up your dads. You need to do that. Because it is not easy being a dad. Nope, it's not easy being a mom either. But right now, it's a celebration for dads. So my prayer for you, may God bless your thoughts, words, and actions as you parent your child. May you lead well with a captured heart and unconditional love. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Happy Father's Day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.